We're at the St. Louis Science Center, and we're going to go see Sue, the T-Rex experience. And Sue's the famous dinosaur skeleton. The real one is still in Chicago, in the Field Museum. It's the largest complete T-Rex skeleton in the world. Sue, the T-Rex experience. And you can buy tickets online, or you can buy them in person.
And we're going in. Yes. Also, hi, I'm here.
So if you're
it's going. There's the ticket prices. It says, please no food or flash photography. It scares the dinosaurs.
But they're dead. How can they be scared?
I don't know. I don't get it. Here we go. And they say it's a multi-sensory experience. So we'll find out what that means in this case.
Is that Sue up there?
Yeah. Welcome. Is this your guys' first time in the exhibit?
Yes.
Before you get too far, you mind if I show you one of my personal favorite pieces in the whole exhibit?
Sure.
This right here is an actual piece of Sue.
Oh,
this
wow.
is no fake. This is no replica. This is an honest-to-goodness dinosaur bone.
Wow.
You see how this piece has ended up, though, just a tad sun-bleached down there at the bottom? This was the rib bone that was sticking out of a South Dakota hillside in August 1990 that Sue Hendrickson would first discover. This is the first piece of Sue ever found.
Wow.
The Genesis. If you actually look underneath your feet, you can see the sketches she made of all the individual bones as she uncovered more and more of the remains. Now, I did want to let you guys know, you arrived just in time to catch our special Sue light show.
Oh, wow.
The bones around Sue are going to go totally dark, and thanks to black light technology, those bones are actually going to glow in the dark. Let me tell you some fun facts about our bony friend. So she had broken ribs and an arthritic tail. To know when the show gets started, if you look underneath Sue, there's a TV screen with timers underneath to let you know when the show gets started.
Okay.
Please enjoy.
Thank you. These are fossils found with Sue, an aquatic plant, sediment and aquatic plants, tibia, that's a lower leg bone of a young T-Rex, and other different parts. And over here is a big screen. And this is what Sue probably looked like.
What have you read about her?
We're going to wait and see if Sue comes out and attacks something. There's some turtles in the water.
I think that dinosaur's already dead. Looks kind of not good.
Yeah, that looks like a dead ankylosaurus. Oh, here comes Sue. Sue wasn't above eating dead animals either.
That's how she got the bad breath.
She even went after fish. Look out, turtle. Oh, she pooped. Well, that's real. So Sue liked her prey dead or alive. She smells us. Cohen, she smells you.
She smells you. You put in your deodorant too much. She smells you.
This is a replica of Sue's skull.
Oh, it says, please touch. Or they want you to touch it.
Yeah, you're allowed to touch this.
Oh, it's really slick.
What'd you think about that, Cohen?
It's insane.
Oh, do you want to touch the tooth?
Wow. Yeah, those are big teeth. Wow. Big jaw.
Wow.
Very cool. And so there's going to be a light show over here pretty soon. It's counting down to the next Sue show.
You see her broken ribs?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, they said she had broken ribs. They said they found the bones of a young T-Rex in the same area.
Huh. It could have been her baby?
I don't know.
It's over there and it's also
yeah.
dead.
12 seconds.
Come take a closer look at Sue's skeleton.
Good job.
Take
You're standing in front of one of the largest predators to ever walk the earth, a Tyrannosaurus rex. And this T-Rex is named Sue. Sue is the most complete, best preserved T-Rex ever found. And that means we can tell this dinosaur story in detail. Sue lived about 67 million years ago in what is now South Dakota. At the time, the landscape was lush and humid, quenched by rivers winding across forested floodplains. This was near the end of the age of dinosaurs, not long before an asteroid impact changed life on Earth forever. T-Rex was well adapted to survive in these forests. Powerful leg muscles helped Sue move quickly over short distances, perfect for ambushing prey among the trees. These jaws could bite down with a force of 8,000 pounds per square inch, enough to crush a pickup truck. Sue needed that bone-shattering bite to bring down giant, dangerous prey. But hunting other dinosaurs wasn't always easy. Even a top predator like Sue risked injury. A close look at the skeleton reveals the evidence. These broken and healed over ribs are among more than a dozen injuries to Sue's bones. Sue managed to survive to old age, but over time, arthritis ravaged these tail joints and fused them together, making it impossible for them to move. Now look down at this Lego. Its lumpy, deformed shape was probably caused by an infection. If you look up at the jaw, you'll see some holes. These may be the result of a disease Sue got from eating infected prey. This jaw infection may have made it so painful to eat that Sue eventually starved. But we don't know everything. There are still some big questions out there. Was Sue male or female? What were those tiny arms used for? Did T-Rex have feathers? Did they hunt in packs or alone? We've learned so much about T-Rex in the last 100 years, and with each new discovery, the more vividly we can see the towering, ferocious, battle-scarred predator that Sue once was.
Thank you all so much for enjoying our light show featuring Sue the T-Rex. You're now free to explore this exhibit to your heart's content. But before you go, for those of you that enjoy a more interactive experience, over there in that back corner, we have a replica of what it's our typical marsupial's fur would have felt like during this period. Over there, we have a replica of what the typical wildlife would have smelled like during this period. And for those daring among you to try, over there in that back corner, we have a replica of what a typical T-Rex's breath would have smelled like.
And all around Sue's skeleton are some informational panels that tell about her. When she lived, the late Cretaceous period. It's found in South Dakota. There's a scale model of Sue. Big head and little arms. And Sue had a lot of battle scars, apparently. And maybe some disease in her jaw. This shows Sue's stiff, arthritic tail. And there's the arthritic section of her tail. And here is her broken, lumpy rib. It shows the spots here where the ribs were broken. This is a real Edmontosaurus tail. Looks like something we saw in Camp Cretaceous. Wow, that's a long tail.
That's crazy.
This is a skeleton of a Triceratops. And these are not real bones. These are recreation of the real bones. These are what they allow to go on tour and to be put in exhibitions. But this is actually a real Triceratops skull. Wow. That's really cool that they have that here. here's what Sue probably looked like with skin on. And there's her unfortunate prey. That's her dinner. And it tells about Sue's prey. It says that Sue was well adapted to hunt and eat other dinosaurs like the Edmontosaurus. Wouldn't be fun to be an Edmontosaurus back in Sue's time. There's an exhibit where you can smell Sue's breath. What it probably smelled like.
So,
Sue's breath. And what do you do?
You lift it up with its mouth and you sniff it.
It's disgusting. Don't take too big a whiff. It's like
Yeah, that's bad. Sue had bad breath. Hate to say it. This also reminds us of Camp Cretaceous. Whose head would this be?
Bumpy's.
Bumpy.
Feel it.
Wow.
I want you to feel it.
That's cool.
Oh, Bobo.
Oh, it really was bumpy.
Yeah.
There's bumps everywhere.
It's an ankylosaurus.
There's its nose. There's its nose.
Oh, yeah. That is awesome.
You want to pick its nose?
Boop his nose.
Pick his nose.
Boop it.
Like armored and dangerous. What lived in rivers and ponds back then? That's a paddlefish. And there is a turtle skull. And these are called Cretaceous cattle. A hadrosaur.
So now we're going to sniff some good smelling stuff.
Better than Sue's breath?
Probably 50 times better.
Sue's home has some lush, green, and wild things around her. So what is this?
This is a little flower.
Smell it.
Smells delicious. It smells like yogurt.
Like yogurt.
Smell it. Sniff it.
Yeah, that's not bad.
That's where yogurt came from.
And this
one's the worst.
What do you call that?
Like a pitcher plant type thing? I don't know what that is.
Okay. I wish you could smell it. Yeah.
And this is the oldest tree I've seen ever. It's a pine tree still.
Okay.
And it smells really, really good.
Yeah, that is a good smell. Not everything smelled bad back then.
It's like a muskrat sort of type thing. It looks scary though.
This is the skeleton of Didelphodon borax, a marsupial mammal. This is some fur that you can touch. Furry, wispy, and soft.
It looks like a possum, but
yeah.
Meaner.
What is this?
A T-Rex jaw.
Is that part of a T-Rex jaw?
This is a replica of a baby T-Rex.
Oh, okay.
You can see how small they start and how big they grow.
Yeah. They grow a whole lot bigger, don't they?
Since you live to be 28 to 33 years old.
Oh, look. There's a little game.
T-Rex was fast enough to catch what? Answer the question, Cohen.
A Jeep.
She could catch an Edmontosaurus. Her jaws were powerful enough to bite through what?
A car door.
Yes.
True. Correct. That's what her roar probably sounded like. Low, rumbly, and deep. And that was the Sue exhibit. That was really cool.